Your speech was like very good. I watched your YouTube videos before coming here, and
I'm sorry, I didn't get the second line. What did you say?
I have watched your YouTube videos prior to coming here.
Okay.
And I was very impressed from your videos as well. So I just want to convey that. Thank you so much for your work. My question is, it's a bit close to my heart. I've been a vegetarian since birth, my mom, she has calcium deficiency. So there is also so much fear of vitamin deficiency, iron deficiency, calcium deficiency. And my problem is that if I change to a vegan diet, that is even more restrictive diet, right? I have a fear of getting those deficiencies and
Okay, we'll just go one by one with each deficiency. Firstly, when you're talking about calcium deficiency, if you were to switch from eating rice to millets, that is ragi millet, you will never be calcium deficient in your life. But then again, there's one more thing. I'm not a doctor, I'm not a medical trained professional, so of course if you want to, please consult your medical professionals if you want to on this. There are some people, despite no matter what they eat, the body doesn't absorb it. In our intestinal tract, we have villi, these little finger-like things that are the ones that absorb the nutrients. For some people, they just don't seem to work as much. For those people, we need supplementation. But if you don't have that issue, which is a very rare case, by the way, if you were to switch from rice to ragi, which is not expensive, there is no way on earth you can be calcium deficient, because 100 grams, this small amount of ragi millet, has 300 plus milligrams of calcium. That is more than, nearly 2/3 of your calcium requirement for the day, from just one small portion. So calcium is done. It's one small change if you make. Now, when you talk about iron deficiency, you have to understand that we have scientific studies showing that vegetarians, that is people who consume a lot of dairy products, are actually more prone to iron deficiency, because the calcium, not the calcium exactly, something found in that milk inhibits iron absorption. Similarly, if you eat a food, say, that is high in iron, something like dal, lentils, tuvar dal, masoor dal, these things are high in iron. Not to mention even your palak and these leafy vegetables are high in iron. When you're eating these iron-rich foods, once you eat them, drink a glass of orange juice along with it. When you consume vitamin C along with iron, the body is able to easily absorb much more of the iron. So I've answered you for calcium and iron. Is there any other nutrient you'd like to particularly ask about?
No, I'm just afraid because I feel like cutting out dairy from my life.
Okay, which dairy products do you consume right now and how much of them do you consume?
Currently, I'm consuming milk. And
twice a day, I would say, twice a day?
No, once a day.
For morning, like a tea, small serving?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I do consume curd.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes there is butter in food, in my food.
So
I cannot control.
Right. So, first of all, I am not here in your mess, so I do not exactly know. We do have a few vegans who are vegans and eat from the mess, so maybe they could guide you better. But I could tell you something. If you can afford certain foods from outsides, it's better to reach nutrient-dense foods. Again, I don't know if you're allowed to cook inside. I don't know if you're allowed to prepare food or stuff. But for example, leafy green vegetables, that's all your, do you speak Tamil?
Yes.
Okay, all your types of kirai. All of these things are very high in all of the micronutrients. Micronutrients means vitamins and minerals. So if you could find a way to include them into your diet, you will get easily a plethora of nutrients. You would not have much difficulties. Like I said, once again, I don't know the exact dishes you get. I'm not aware of it. But you could probably ask your friends here and they could probably guide you through, because I understand how scary it is in the beginning, because the first time I stopped drinking milk, when I woke up the next day in the morning, I was like, are my limbs still attached to my body? Did they fall off? Because that's how much you've been told, you have to drink milk. But trust me, do it for a week or something, you'll realize it's not a big deal. But yes, you do have to eat a balanced diet, because deficiencies don't show their head immediately, they come after a few months. Do some research. There's a website online or an app known as Chronometer. Have you heard of it? This is an app that shows you, if you put in the food you eat with the amount, how much nutrients you're getting. And again, nutritional requirements vary. I am 6'4" and I weigh 90 kilograms. Surely you don't have to eat as much as I do to get your nutrients. From gender also it varies. So you can input there your height, your weight, your gender, your physical activity, everything. It'll give you a neat chart as to how much of each nutrient you need. You can then punch in what you are eating, and you can make sure you're getting your nutrients. It is very much possible and doable to get all of your nutrients from plant sources, except B12, You have to supplement. You have to supplement B12 and don't stay indoors all days. Do expose your skin to sunlight if you want to get vitamin D. And the last thing I want to say is, if I were at your mess, and me being an ethical vegan, for me in the end of the day, my beliefs matter the most. Now, I don't want to be someone who's deficient in some kind of nutrient and then promote veganism. But if I were in your place, through hook or crook, through some way, I will ensure that I find a way or a means to meet my nutritional requirements as a vegan, because I just think whatever little inconvenience I will have to do, if it is an inconvenience to be a vegan, is nothing compared to whatever suffering these animals are going through. That's what I would say.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.